And we're back. We are back. We are alive. Back at the house. That was my first death on this profile. I'm sure you guys watched the rally and watched me get killed by a bus. That was not expected. I really genuinely thought the bus driver would stop. I don't know why I thought that. This is my summer car. And the guy that drives the bus is completely insane. And as I was pointed out to me in the comments, I was holding a trophy full of my own urine, so why would he even stop anyway? I don't know. I don't know what was going through my mind. I was holding a trophy, and I just thought, yeah, this seems like a good idea. I did not expect that to happen. Actually, I think, I don't know. I need to watch it. I know he cuts the bend. I think that might be what killed me. I thought to get out of the way, but I seem to remember he cuts that corner. Since then, there's been a patch in the game. Look at this. Look at this! Oh my god! It's a scooter! I mean, you know what? I remember being 6 or 7 years old, and a friend of mine who lived on a farm had one of these things. And let me tell you, they are hilarious. They are great fun. The only problem is, I think we need to get some fuel for it. Because I think the... Okay, let me just break it. I think it takes its own two-stroke fuel, which is probably a mixture of gasoline and two-stroke engine oil, because it's a two-stroke engine, so you have to put the... Normally, you put the gasoline and mix in yourself, but I think with this game, you buy it from the shop. So first things first, I need to get my car and my trophy back before it goes completely dark. Quickest way to do that is probably to take the boat. I can't be bothered to, because that way I don't have to take a vehicle over there. So while we're there, I think what we'll do is we'll take a boat over there. And I'll get some two-stroke fuel. And then we'll put that in the car. And then we'll drive the car and the trophy back here. And then we'll be able to fill up the little scooter thing. I'm so excited to give that a go. I'm trying to think about what I could do with that scooter. I'm immediately thinking about being an idiot and driving down the train line and playing chicken with the train. I'm not sure that's a good idea either. But what I do need to do, we've got our money, we've got 11,600. Also, the boat now takes fuel, in case you didn't know. It should hopefully come full of fuel, but see, there's a little cap on there now. I presume this is two-stroke as well. I'm 100%, I'm almost 100% certain that's going to be... two-stroke fuel in there. So I think now here's an interesting thing. If your boat runs out of two-stroke fuel when it's near the shop, you're fine. You can walk to the shop, get some fuel, come back and fill it up. If your boat runs out of fuel when it's down here, it's not fine, because actually, thinking about this, I need to buy a number of those fuels. Then I need to probably leave one on the island for safekeeping. And probably need to leave a bunch of them back here. So that if we ever run out of fuel at home, we can fill up the scooter and we can fill this thing up. Yeah, that's what we'll do. Alright, so here's the plan. Get back to the car, get the trophy, drive over to the shop, buy a load of fuel, two-stroke fuel. Probably need to fill the car up again as well, because we've just done a race. I want to tune the car as well. I want to bring the tuning back up. We had it, if you remember, we tuned the mixture so that it was better for the race, but it's a bit easy to stall as it stands, so I want to adjust the mixture back so it's easy to drive day-to-day basis. And yeah, at some point, I don't know if the boat is going to get left over there when I drive back and then we go to sleep. I don't know if the boat gets reset or whether the boat will stay over there. I honestly don't know the answer to that one. If the boat stays over here, then that's a pain. That's a pain, because you know, you're always going to end up with one vehicle over here, because if you drive back over here and drive the boat back, your vehicle's back over there. The only thing I can think of is once the little scooter's up and running, what you could do is drive all the way around the map on the scooter and then put the scooter in the boat and drive the boat back with the scooter. I don't know if this thing will hold a scooter in it or whether it will glitch out and fall in the water. And here's the other thing I've been thinking, right? So if this thing runs out of fuel, like let's say it runs out of fuel right now, what the heck do you do? Like, in all seriousness, swimming in this game is almost impossible. And just look at the distances involved. That's basically death. And if you run out of fuel on there as well, I mean, that's basically death, isn't it? So I'm not massively keen on the idea of having to add fuel in this. You better make sure it doesn't run out. That's all I can say. Actually, one thing that I think they should add in this game, now that we've got this situation where loads of things need fuel, I think they need to add the ability to buy more jerry cans. I love that place. So cool. You need to be able to buy jerry cans, I think, because you've only got one by default, and it's just not going to be enough, is it? So I reckon it would be handy to have a jerry can back at your house, one in the car, one at your little log cabin, etc. I think it would be tremendously handy if you could buy more. But anyway, it's a lovely day, mostly. In theory, actually, I'm sure when you die, you end up with a gravestone in the cemetery at the church over here. Maybe we should have a little look after we've got the stuff from the shop. I'm sure that's how it works. Every death that you have, if you have permadeath turned on, well, rip. But if you don't, then I think you end up with a little monument thing somewhere in the cemetery. I've not actually checked that to see if it happens or not. Actually, I don't remember that bit so much. What is that? Is that the road just comes down to the water, though? That's interesting. Imagine if he added in the game trailers, so you could tow a trailer, and on the trailer you could put a boat, and you could bring the boat down here, and oh, he needs to add jet skis, doesn't he? He needs to put some ramps in here. That's what he needs to do. He needs to put a little ramp in here so you can drive around and just like jump off the ramps. Maybe they could add a little competition as well, like doing tricks. Man, there's so many things I can think of he could do. I was going to say something else then, I've forgotten what it was now. Blimey. There were just ideas popping up in my head then. Oh yeah, that was it. One of the things they've added as well is, you know the Wubwub car? I think he's put a tow point on it for a laugh. Which basically means you could bring the truck over here, attach yourself to Mr. Wubwub and start towing him. Just for the lols. I think I read that in the Reeves notes. Kill that. Lovely jubbly. Look at that stop. I'll walk the rest of the way. Let's think. Right, the shop's that way, which means the car is trying to get my bearings over here, because it should be at the crossroads where I got killed. And hopefully my trophy's still there as well. Can we take a shortcut through the cemetery? I know there are some gaps in the wall, but I can't remember where they are. What the heck? Look at that tree! Why is that tree red? Oh, there's a monument. That can't be it. That's way too big. I'm expecting, like, you know when they used to, you know the cowboy films and they bury people in the desert? And it's a case of a pile of rocks and a couple of sticks in the shape of a cross. I'm kind of expecting that. Right, here's the entrance. Okay, so this is the church area, this is the cemetery. I'm just looking around to see if there's like a headstone anywhere. I don't actually see one. I'm sure it used to do that. Or at least I read it. I've never seen it, but I'm sure I read it. Let's have a look what this says on it. This is a massive monument. Okay. In memory of testers. Okay. So the testers have got a monument. I can't actually see my own gravestone anywhere. Am I in the right place? This does seem like the right place, unless there's another graveyard. I can hear that bus. Do you know what? I'm going to make it my mission to try and kill the bus driver now. Because as far as I'm concerned, he's a scumbag, he's a weirdo, and he's murdered me. So I'm wondering if I can take the truck into him fast enough. Oh, there's my trophy. Yay! If I can take the trophy, if I can take the truck into him. Doesn't look dented. Fast enough, can I kill him? Yo! Did you see a murder? Did you see what happened to me, pal? I'm back from the dead. I'm not saying I'm amazing, but I got first place and I'm back from the dead. That takes some doing, you know. Right, let's hope this thing has not been damaged. I don't think it got hit by the bus. Yeah. Mosquito spray, beer. Whoop. See what I mean? It's just like, it's a bit cold, but, and I didn't even bother with a choke this time. Actually, fuel level is pretty low, so I think we will fill up on fuel while we're here. Yeah, you will drive off, pal. You will drive off, because I was just going to come over and have words with you. And when I say have words, I mean, your card is marked, mate. Your card is marked. You're gonna die. We're gonna have a gravestone. That cemetery is gonna have a place for you. Here lies the bus driver. I mean, you thought Wubbub died in a bad way? You just wait what happens to him. We're talking like... Actually, I wonder if I can push him into the water. Wait a minute. I've got an idea. I've just had an idea. You know, on the main road, the railway track crosses the main road on the right-hand side of the map. So what if... Oh, the bus driver, does he go that way? I think I can find a place where the bus driver goes. And what it can do... What I could do is park my truck in front of the lines and block him in. I can block him in and then the train can massacre him. Oh yeah, I've got plans for you, matey. I have so got plans for you. I might go, because he turns right at the bottom though, doesn't he, I think, if I remember the bus routing. We need to go that way and have a look. Hey! Hey to the dishes and dishes to the dishwasher. What? You random dude. Oh, two-stroke fuel. Hello. Cool. Right, hang on. We'll have 99 mark. 1, 2, 3, 4. You know what? We'll clean you out. We'll have the whole lot. I'm feeling a bit thirsty as well. I'm about to close the store, so shake that little booty. Lol. Have some milk. Do we have any more of this stuff? I don't think we do. But I'll buy one more of those and one more of those. Won't bother with that one. Just in case. And because, well, you know, it's bound to happen that I want to brew some more stuff. In it. Right, how much is that? 800. You're talking to the Rally Gold Medal winner here. I can afford... Oh, God. I didn't actually think this through, did I? I forgot he'd give me these one at a time. RIP. Okay. I'm getting out your shop, don't worry. I'm out your shop now. I'm going to be utter lazy now and drive this thing around. I can't believe my seats are still low. Interesting fact, right? You know, I've mentioned to you the idea of getting rid of your stuff. Like a proper bin. Well, turns out if you put something in a sewer... Yeah, you know the little sewer cover things. If you put something in there, it reappears on the rubbish tip. I'll show you the rubbish tip as well at some point. Why won't you pick up? I'll show you the rubbish tip. Hey, is my trophy still in there? Yeah. So that's a, it doesn't permanently delete it from the game world, but it puts it on the rubbish tip, which is just as good as. The trouble is, I don't think you could get one of those chairs inside a sewerage thing, but what you could do is take it to the rubbish tip, if you were so inclined. Now, I need a drink, which means I'm going to have a beer. You can keep this, it's a gift. There you go. Right then, how are we looking? A bit damaged, but otherwise not too bad. Yo, bro.
Hey, onks tää nyt se Peräjärve kova jatka olevina?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Onks tää osaks tää mitään tehdä?
You might talk a big game, matey. But, you know, you're talking to the rally winner. Can you win a rally in that thing? I doubt it. Where's the toe point in this thing? There it is, look. It's true. There's a towing hook. Oh my god, that could be so fun. I'm going to have so much fun with that. Right, I'm going to drive this thing back. And we'll pick it up when I get back at the house. Here we are, back at base. Look at the sun! I don't remember the sun doing that in this game. Look at that effect. That's actually quite cool. It goes right through the tree as well, which is even more impressive. But in all honesty, I think that must be new, because I don't remember that. We need to put the trophy on the mantelpiece. I also want to kickstart the... how tired are we? Oh, not too bad, actually. Put it like, well, like that, because it just stalled anyway. There we go. That'll do. Lol. Unbuckle the harness. Kill the lights. We're back. All right. Let's close the door, and we shall grab that. That. Oh no, the bag. The bag's exploded. What a scumbag! That. This little beauty. Come on, crouch down. There we go. Don't want to damage that thing, do we? And that. Oh my god. I can't believe you have to do this. This is such a trolley thing. Right, I'm going to drink that. Over there, that over there. Go over there. I bet half of this is going in the boot. Just because of the way the game clips. Empty pack. Put that over here. And that. Nope, boot's good. Right, we're going to dump this in here. We'll sort this stuff out in a minute. Let's, first things first, let's get the great first place trophy onto, let's turn it around. Look at that. Oh yeah. OCD hype. There it is. Beautiful. Mum and Dad's going to wonder what the heck has been happening when they come home. Honey, did you enter a rally and win? I may have done. Right, let's see if we can fill this up. Do you have to unscrew that? No. Okay. Let's do this. Let's grab that. Hopefully this works. Okay. Why is that not happening? You don't usually need to open a container, do you? Hmm. It's It's not working, is it? The Jonas ES, it's called. Why won't you fill up? If it works like, you know, the radiators and stuff, it should just fill up, shouldn't it? What do I need to do to it? That's interesting. Lid back on. Any other controls? Alright, we'll figure it out. We'll figure that out. Let's get all this stuff inside. And, we'll figure out what's going on. I actually need to check on the Killua as well to see how that's going. This thing can go in the garage. God, it's like doing jobs for real, this. Bringing the shopping home. Putting it all the way in the cupboard. Let's get them over there. Let's open that up. That can go over there with all the other ones, nice and tidy. This one can go on the bottom shelf. Like that. That'll do. Don't know why that's here, but that can go over there as well. Now, we're going to need these things. So we'll put these... I think we might need this in the morning when we figure out how to... fill the scooter up with fuel. I don't quite understand why it's not filling up. Okay, sugar can go in there. Can't believe the bag. Thing is, what, like, he serves stuff in a bag, but then you can't put things in bags yourselves. It's just so, right, how ridiculous is that? Why can't you buy a bag and just fill it up? Oh well, we'll sort that out in a minute. Right, let's have a look at the situation here. We've got three that need emptying. One that needs emptying. Actually, no. Tell a lie. Two that need emptying. That's the one near the rally point. That's where we died. The rally point is here. The one around the corner. That's two. That one there is the MOT test center. Or the vehicle test center. So we've got three to fill up, which is not enough. We need 10,000 liters to empty it on the MOT test center. That's only going to give us 2,500. 2,500 each, which is 7,500 in total. So I need one more job before we go doing that. We're not going to get paid for it, though. We're going to get, like, silly amounts of ultra-strong beverage. Failing that, there's wood that needs to be taken. We can get a bit of money that way. There's also, I believe, one more scrap that we could recover. So we could do that for money. But essentially, we're on like 10k at the moment. We need to get up to about, I think it's about 18 to get a full metallic paint job done. But we've also got loads of like body panel problems, so I don't really want to... I can't remember if the metallic paint job actually fixes the bodywork as well. I need to double check that. But I don't want to get it all sprayed up unless it's going to look absolutely mint. But 18,000 is a lot of money to save up. Anyway, first thing we need to do is... probably have a quick drink. And then we're going to go to sleep. Because it's like 11. Do you know what? I'm just going to unplug that. Because I don't want to be called by some idiot from the pub. Wakey wakey. Oh, yeah. What time is it? Wow, that was like a full-on 9-hour kip. That's incredible. That's actually incredible. Is there anything in the fridge to eat? Why have I just got milk? Why is all the food not in there? Let's have a bag, Chris. That'll keep us going. Just make us thirsty. Right, today we're going to try and figure out how to get the scooter thing to work. That's the plan. Come on, give it a quick shake. Blimey, it's one of those nights. You know those nights you wake up in the morning and you just seem to be able to take a wee forever? And you're like, where did my body store all this? I'm pretty certain my bladder isn't that big. It happens. It's happened to everybody. Right, it's a beautiful day. So now we try and work out how to use the scooter. So it turns out that I'm being a complete idiot. And what I need to do is, well, I can pick it up, first of all. That's one thing. So if I just rest it like that. Dude. I can pick it up, and here's the killer. I didn't expect him to do this, but what he's done is he's modeled it correctly, so it actually has a fuel tap. The real thing has a fuel tap on it, and I didn't expect him to put it on there. I think the reason we can't pour two-stroke fuel in there is because it's already full. So there's a fuel tap there, there's some lights here, and then there's an engine shut off, and then obviously the ignition. So I think the way that you start this thing is you get on like that, and then you lean, turn the fuel tap on, and then put it into gear. Well, drop the clutch and put it into gear. Because it's not an automatic gearbox either. It's actually a manual gearbox. And there you go. That's how you drive it. So much fun. The thing is, this thing has like, what, four gears? Which is completely insane. But here's the thing. You don't have to walk around anymore. You've got your own little moped thing. So, I mean, when you're chopping up the wood, you can drive over there with this and then, you know, chop up the wood and then drive the tractor and just put this inside. You don't have to walk between buildings. One thing I need to do is I need to take the car and get the thing, get the bodywork done. So one thing we'll do is we'll take this insane beast. We'll take this insane beast with us. I'll try and fit it in the back of the car now. Actually, I don't know if it'll fit. Shuts off. I also don't know what happens if you don't put the fuel tap back on. Yeah, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and put this in the back of here. Let's see how this goes. There you go. God. That may or may not be a good idea. There we go. It's stable, I think, mostly. Yeah, that's good enough. Did I unplug the phone? I did. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to drive down. We're going to leave the car with the mechanic. And you can see how bad this car is now. It's all bent out of shape. This is not looking like a rally winner. And it needs to look like a rally winner. I'll tell you what I was going to do. I was going to tune it, wasn't I? Let's do that before we go anywhere. Pop the bonnet thing. Where is it? Let's get my tools before we go. We'll tune it back up again so it's a bit easy to drive. There's the toolkit. I need the screwdriver. Right, where are you? There we go. Okay, let's make sure it's all warmed up first before we do anything. Temperature gauge is there. Get it up to running temperature, and then what we're going to do is, because at the moment the mixture is set to like the low end of that green bar, and I want to push it up a bit more towards the middle. That's what I'm trying to do. Make sure the choke is definitely off. Now, I'm not sure where the needle should be sitting. I think it should be sitting about here. Think he's up to temperature if we just idle it for a second. Nah, it still feels a little bit like it's... I tell you what we'll do is we'll take the screwdriver set with us. Take the tools with us, and when we get there, the engine will be properly warm. Let's hope all that stays in there. And we'll tune it when we get there before we hand it over. Whee! Can I get off the roof, please? Thank you. Okay, buckle up. Brake off. Whoa, the sunshine just went a bit... The sun just went in then, it all went a bit darker. It's a bit weird. Okay, let's get down to the mechanics. Here we are. Down on the mechanic. You can see the mixture now. The engine temperature's back up, the mixture changes. So I'm just going to let it idle. Quick tune. I'm going to need to have a quick vehicle inspection as well. Because we need to know what bits to tell him to repair. Where's the lights? Kill the lights a second. We don't need that. Harness. Right. Where's my toolkit? Oh, are you serious, game? Don't tell me you left it on the drive or something ridiculous. Let's get the bike out of there. I think it's gone. Oh no, it's there. Whew. It'd fallen underneath. I thought for a minute there it had gone and left it on the driveway. Right, what's the mixture on? Currently rocking 14.0. Let's put the tool in and adjust. 1, 2, 3. Let's have a look what that gives us. Wrong way. Okay, 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 the other way. 14.7. Yeah, I like that. That'll do. 14.7 will do. Toolkit. We can't bring this with us. So we're going to have to leave it in the back. Now, in terms of what we want to get done here, let's make a little note. We've got the whole front, the subframe, is completely bent out of shape. So that needs doing. The left door needs doing. The rear light, or is it the car body? I'm not sure. This side seems to be fairly okay. The right door's a little bit bent as well. Okay, let's go and have a look at his list.
Terve, terve.
Dude, shush. Boile mielessä. What does that mean? Wheel alignment, brake check and repair, repair of broken engine parts, engine adjustment, motor tuning, windshield replacement, roll cage install, final gear change, not bothered about. Right, car body. So we're looking at car body. Oh my god, that's $8,000. Oh no, it's not. It's 50% discount. Door left, door right. Hood, boot lid, bumper front, bumper rear. Car body is presumably the subframe. Fender left, fender right. Boot lid. Bumper front and rear. How much is it for the whole lot? $8,000 for the whole lot. We can afford to do that everything. And then we know that, like, it's 100% done. That's going to give us a sheet metal and rust repair. And then once that's done, the only thing we need to do is save up enough money to get it sprayed up. So maybe we should just do the whole thing.
I know.
I don't want your Ferndale. Your Ferndale sucks, matey. Yeah, Spirito di Punto. Whatever. Right, there we go. That's the car in there. We've now got just... It's just us and the bike or the Ferndale. We've got a choice now. Ferndale or bike? That's the question. Ferndale or bike? I think I'm going to leave it there. In the next episode, I'll make a decision about what to use to drive back. I may just go with the moped thing, just for the lols. We'll see. That's it from me. Please give me a like if you enjoyed the video. Other than that, take care. Happy driving.